Hi, I'm Janek Gwizdala, and we are listening to the brand new Bitmap version 2 from Red Panda. Before we get to the music, we have for the first time on my channel a sponsor for this video. Perfect Circuit here in Los Angeles is one of the most comprehensive pedals, effects, recording gear, pro audio, and modular synth stores I have ever visited. And if you follow me on Instagram or are in my Discord server, you will have seen me posting crazy photos from the store when I go down there to pick up new pieces for my rig. It's where I got the Chase Bliss Dark World, the Hungry Robot Moby Dick, the Chox DC7, and most recently the GFI Systems Specular Tempest. It's basically a pedal fan's dream come true, all under one roof. They are super knowledgeable cats who have an incredible amount of stock, a massive showroom, and most importantly, ship worldwide. So if you're lucky enough to be in the Southern California area, I highly recommend going to check out the store. But if you're anywhere else in the world and just looking to get hold of something serious in the land of pedals or modular synths, then check out their Baller website. I must give this important disclaimer. I cannot be responsible for you losing at least 4 hours of your life browsing their website. There is an almost limitless amount of cool stuff, and your gear acquisition syndrome is going to be flaring up as soon as you click on the link in the description below. Now, let's get back to the show. Let's be very clear that I was not a user of the original Bitmap, so this video is not an update about how the two differ. I'm also not going to shoot it out against some of the classic bit crushers I have in my collection, and here's why. I think this pedal is so feature rich that I'm A, probably not even going to be able to do it justice in just one video, and B, you can't simply call it just a bit crusher. And please don't leave me comments like, why don't you just play all the sounds of the pedal? This channel is not a review channel, it's just my take on cool pedals that make cool sounds. And the pinnacle of mining their depths can't be reached without being creative with your signal chain. I don't mean to put things out of reach if your budget doesn't quite run to some of the combinations in this video, but rest assured, not only does the Bitmap make amazing sounds on its own, you really don't have to go that crazy to blow those sounds into the next solar system with a few signal chain tweaks. The Bitmap has multiple LFO options, a low pass filter, tap tempo, modulation, depth and rate controls, presets, a desktop browser edit. I mean, when was the last time you saw all of this in just a bit crusher? Now, if you know my playing a little, then you know I'm a huge Iron Ether fan, and the Franta bit is a permanent fixture on my board. I'm also a big fan of the Bug Brand Bug Crushers, something I got hip to by my good friend John Davis. And we've actually both more recently adopted the Otto Bit Junior by Maris into our board, as it too has some incredible sample rate reduction and bit crushing options. So where does the Bitmap V2 fit into this world of sample rate reduction? Well, just about everywhere, it seems. I've only had the pedal for a few days and have already been able to come up with some incredibly inspiring sounds. And that, for me, is the name of the game. Does it make you want to play music, and does it help you find things you might never have heard otherwise? If a pedal passes those two tests, then there's no question as to its value. It actually moves into the category for me of being priceless when it helps with the process of musicality and originality. Let's get a basic use case dialed in first. For any John Davis, JoJo Mayer, Nerve, and general electronic music fans out there, let me show you how the Bitmap can do that thing. So when you pair the Bitmap with something like a Boss OC2 with the JoJo Mayer setting, you're pretty much in business. You'll be glad to hear I'm not going to break your wallet if you want this sound and can't afford a vintage Boss pedal, as I'm actually using the MXR Vintage Bass Octave in this entire video. Thank you. aside from the more conventional things you might want from a bit crusher, I think the really fun stuff happens when we dig deeper into the pedal and start exploring. Using the very handy Chrome browser editor, I was, for instance, able to map the envelope filter to the control port and use an expression pedal to sweep through the entire frequency range as I play. I also created a couple of presets as I was experimenting with sounds. Being able to capture that sound as soon as you find it and not having to guess where all the settings were sometime later is a big win. Simply select the preset slot you want to store the sound in and hold the button down for 2 seconds until you see the green light flash. As you listen to some playing examples from my time with the pedal, I would encourage you to leave comments and questions below if there's anything you would like to know more about. I think in the few days I've had the pedal, I've only just started to scratch the surface, and I get the impression this is something I could really use as an instrument when I'm improvising live. Whether it's searching for sounds like Square Pusher's Bonneville Occident from Go Plastic, or creating kind of lo-fi droning soundscapes that you might associate with a sci-fi movie, I think the Bitmap has a lot of range. For these next examples, I now have the Bitmap and the Vintage Bass Octave in my larger Vertex Effects pedal board, full video about this new project coming soon, via the exotic Stereo X Blender to make use of some modulation, delays, and reverbs, and really give you an idea of what this thing can do when it's driving a much bigger picture signal chain. And just before we get to these final sound clips, I want to be very clear that Red Panda did not sponsor this video or send me the pedal, and neither today's sponsor, Perfect Circuit, or Red Panda had any say in what I say about it to you. You guys know I just love to make cool sounds with cool pedals, and I think the Bitmap V2 falls very solidly into that category. Thanks for watching. Please consider hitting the thumbs up and subscribing to the channel if you dig what you've seen, and I'll see you guys soon. Thank you.
Thank you.